In this video, I'll demonstrate some of the new features we've added to the graphical viewer to make resetting origins and flipping strands more clear. I'll show this by finding the A2M gene on chromosome 12. I'll start with the graphical view already open to chromosome 12 from the URL shown below. From here, I'll search for the gene A2M. In the search results box, here's A2M and it's on the negative strand. I'll select it and close the dialog. I want to reset the origin to the start of the gene's initiation codon. To find that spot, I'll use the HGVS term and search for NM_000014.4, which is the gene's accession, followed by a colon and C.1, where C.1 means the first nucleotide in the initiation codon. The viewer then places a new marker at this position. From here, I'll hover over the marker and then copy the position. Now, to reset the origin to the beginning of the gene, I'll right-click on the ruler and choose Set Sequence Origin at Position. In the dialog, I'll paste in the position I copied earlier. Now we see the rulers changed. We have this new ruler on the bottom that measures in the reset coordinate frame, and the top ruler is the original. We also show this red part of the ruler. The red always points toward the start of the submitted sequence. This keeps us oriented now and also when we flip strands. And we can do that to present the gene on the other strand. From the Tools menu, click on Flip Strands. We see our origin is still at the start of the gene, but the red points the other way now because we're looking at the complementary strand. There's also a C in the title to remind us that this is the complementary strand. Okay, so now let's select a range. If the origin is reset, selections happen in reset coordinates. So, for example, let's show the range from 1K to 2K. Because the origin has been reset, the viewer doesn't know which side of the origin we're referring to, so we have to tell it. We do that in this dialog. Here we see the origin with red representing the direction toward the submitted sequence origin. Then we have to tell the viewer if we want 1,000 to 2,000 on the left of the origin, 1,000 on the right and 2,000 on the left, 1,000 on the left and 2,000 on the right, or both 1,000 and 2,000 on the right. In this dialog, the more negative number is closer to the submitted sequence origin. I'll choose 2,000 toward the submitted sequence origin and 1,000 on the other side of the reset origin. We can avoid this dialog if we use plus and minus signs in the find box. For example, if I find minus 1K to minus 2K, we get exactly that range. This range is on the red side of the origin, pointing toward the submitted sequence origin. As always, there's more you can do. Please visit the NCBI website.